starring June Lockhart, Hugh Riley, John Provost as Timmy, and, of course, Lassie.
Gosh, Lassie, look what happened to the mailbox. And our fence. Come on, girl.
You're not hurt.
I'm okay. Lassie held him off so I could get away. He's in our south pasture.
You mean he's still there?
Uh-huh. Lassie and I could drive him to the corral.
Oh, no, you'll do nothing of the sort.
Porters. Oh, yeah, he's here, Jenny. Hold on a minute. Paul?
Yeah?
Telephone. It's your wife.
Oh, thanks. Hi, dear. Just caught me in time.
Paul, that bull is in our south pasture again.
What? Well, yes, yes, of course, Ruth, right away. Are you sure Timmy's all right?
Yes, but believe me, it's lucky Lassie was with him. He might have been killed.
Now, listen, Ruth. Well, never mind. Mr. Dunlap just came into the store. I'll take care of it right away. Yeah. Bye, dear.
How are you, Mr. Dunlap?
Fine, thank you, Dan.
Hello, Martin.
Mr. Dunlap, that bull of yours got loose again. He broke into my south pasture.
Oh, don't get upset, Martin. You know I'll pay for any damage.
It isn't that simple. He nearly killed my boy.
Was he hurt?
Fortunately, no. But if that animal comes onto my property again, I'll have every legal right to shoot him.
You've made your point, Martin. Let me give you some advice. Don't do anything you'll be sorry for. That bull's a grand champion.
A fancy pedigree doesn't make him any less of a menace. He's still in my pasture.
I'll see to it that Mac's over there right away.
Good. Behind him, girl. Come on, get moving. Keep after him, Lassie.
that dog away from him. You're only riling more.
I was just trying to head him into the corral for you.
I was in a corral with him this morning. That's how I got this. Got me cornered near kill me before he ran off. I'd rather work with him in the open. There's more room to get out of the way.
He's your bull. Handle him any way you want.
I'm not gonna let him get close enough to bash my head in again.
You know, he knows he's got you scared.
Maybe. No ornery bull's gonna make me quit my job.
Keep that up and you'll lose an eye.
That brute's got me too jumpy to do anything.
Hey, you want me to try?
No, don't bother. I got a better way. Can I borrow a pail? I want to make some mash.
Yeah, sure. In the barn. I've got some bran, too, if you want it.
I'll just need enough so he'll swallow some sedative pills. That'll calm him down.
Good idea. Come on, Lassie. We better do as Max says and keep you out of sight for a while. Come on.
Timmy, he's gonna put some tranquilizer in it.
This stuff quiets him down, but it won't hurt him.
I told Mr. Dunlap that I wouldn't be responsible for what happens if that bull comes on my property again.
You better get the boy out of the way till I get the bull on the truck.
And he's right, Timmy. You and Lassie better go in the house, huh?
I'll put this stuff away first, Dad.
Okay. Come on, Mac. I'll give you a hand.
Okay. That stuff won't take long to work. I'll take the pail back.
Oh, don't worry about the pail. I'll take care of it.
I think I left my lead pole in the barn.
It's right there, against the tree.
Oh, thanks. Well, I better get the bull back while the getting's good.
Mr. Martin here? Over here! Martin?
Oh, hello. Don't tell me that bull got out again.
My bull died this morning.
Oh, that's too bad. How did it happen?
He was poisoned.
Mac, could it have been that tranquilizer you gave him yesterday?
No, that sedative wouldn't have killed him.
I wouldn't try blaming it on to Mac. I had my vet do an autopsy. It was strychnine.
Oh, wait a minute, Dunlap. Where are you going?
Just thought I'd have a look around your barn.
Well, just keep one thing in mind. I had nothing to do with it. Go ahead. Well, there's the brand. We use is in that jug under the workbench.
This doesn't smell like molasses to me. This is weed killer, Martin.
This is molasses.
This concentrate says 35% strychnine. Mac, do you know what drug he gave you?
I never paid no attention, Mr. Dunlap. I had my hands full as it was rounding up that bull.
But you can be sure I gave him the right one.
Come on, Mac. I found out what I wanted to know.
Look, Dunlap, poisoning dumb animals isn't my way of settling things.
That's for the law to decide. Don't try to destroy that jug. I've got Mac as a witness.
You mean you're taking this into court?
What do you think? That bull was worth $10,000.
$10,000?
That's right. I hope you have enough money to pay the judgment.
Imagine accusing you of such a thing.
Fortunately, I've got to find a way to clear myself.
How?
You know, last time I used this bottle, it was half full. It's still half full. I'm going into town.
Well, I'll come with you.
All right, we'll pick up Timmy and Lassie on our way past the school.
Now, state law says I have to keep the date, name, and address.
Well, I wonder if you can tell me whether anybody's purchased strychnine lately.
Strychnine? Well, that could be a lot of people, you know, rat poison strychnine. A lot of trappers upstate come in here asking for it.
Yes, I know, but I'd like to know whether anybody from around here has bought it. It's pretty important.
Mm-hmm. Well, now let's take a look.
Did you find what you wanted?
No, I'm afraid not.
Gosh, Dad. Mom, tell me what happened.
Oh, I thought it was best, dear. Don't you worry, though. Dad'll figure something out.
Sorry, I can't be of any more help.
Well, I suppose that the poison could have been bought somewhere else.
Yeah, that's right. But unless you got the package or the bottle that has the label on it, you'd be on a wild goose chase.
Yeah, I guess you're right. Well, thanks, Dan. Come on.
You and Lassie go and play for a while.
Gee, thanks, Mom.
You still got some time till supper.
Come on, Lassie. Work. So you be real quiet and stay close to me.
What were you looking for, kid?
The same thing you and Mr. Dunlap were looking for over at our farm yesterday.
Strychnine?
No, Lassie, no!
That's right. You tell your dog to behave.
Then you just let me go.
Sure. Now, you better head for home, kid. You won't find any strychnine around this place.
What's in that bottle, then?
Tranquilizers. Same stuff I used yesterday. Here, see for yourself.
I can find out if they aren't.
Yeah?
If it's strychnine, there's a record. They keep the sale listed in a book.
Well, you're pretty smart for a kid. That's tranquilizer just the same. Here, show your father. If you don't believe me, go on.
Okay. Come on, Lassie.
And don't stick your nose around here again.
Check it, Dad?
Yes, I will, Timmy. But I'm sure it must be what he says it is, or he wouldn't have given it to you.
And you had no business going there.
But if Dad's in trouble, it's my trouble, too.
Well, of course, dear, we know that. But you can't help by making matters worse. Trespassing on Mr. Dunlap's property.
And that's how Lassie growled at Mac.
I think Lassie's saying she's had enough excitement for one day. And so have you, young man. Off to bed with you.
Maybe you're tired, but I'm not.
Good night.
Come on, Lassie. Night.
What were you doing back there?
I think he threw something away. Over there, I saw him. I bet Lassie saw it too. Go find it, girl, hurry.
I don't know what the kid's talking about. That's enough.
Look, Dad.
Yeah, it's a strychnine, all right. Good girl, Lassie. I don't think the sheriff will have too much trouble figuring out who bought this. Come on.
Come on, let's go.
Well, the sheriff says they have a clear-cut case against Mac now that he's admitted getting that poison in Creston.
Did you hear that, Lassie? And we wanted to help, too, didn't we?
And you certainly did.